everyone, and welcome to Cooking with John. And I haven't done a video in such a long time, but since we're all in lockdown, I thought I would show you how I make cultured butter, which is a little bit different than regular butter. It's gonna take about a couple of days for it to ferment, and you're gonna come out with this delicious butter with a little bit of a tang to it. I really like it as opposed to a regular store-bought butter. And it's very simple. You want a container to put your cream, heavy whipping cream. Pasteurized cream is the best, but I couldn't find any, so I'm using heavy whipped cream that's just pasteurized. It's not ultra pasteurized, which you can use, but it's better not to. It's just because they've taken out a lot of the good components of the cream when they ultra pasteurize it. You're gonna use Kefir, or you can use cultured buttermilk as your basis for your active bacteria culture to go into your cream. And I'm only gonna use a quarter cup of this. I'm using Kefir. You wanna definitely make sure that it's plain, not a flavor one or a sugar one. And I've got some organic here, and I'm gonna put 2 pints in and about a quarter cup of this, stir it, and then I'm gonna cover it up, and then we let it sit for 2 days. So it's a pretty simple thing to do, just like you would do, and then you're gonna whip it like any other regular butter that you would ever make. Sorry, for some reason my voice is a little scratchy today. There's a little bit of a mess there. So, here I've got my beaker. I like a beaker because it's got straight lines, easy to get it all out. You're gonna get buttermilk out of this. That's incredible. It tastes better than your store-bought, and it's actually not thick like your stuff that you buy in the store. And you can save some of this to use it to go back into another batch if you prefer to. You can keep it in your refrigerator for a long time. Mine never lasts more than a couple days because I love it, a little pepper in it. So, got the kefir, if I have that right on there, yep. And I'm just gonna pour a quarter cup of this in here. To activate the good bacteria, and of course, I did not bring my spoon. Shame on me, sorry about that. So, give that a little bit of a stir there, all that good stuff in there. And I had let the cream out just to get it more room temperature, but not a worries. Definitely want it not in a cold place because you want the bacteria to grow fast. And what happens is that the good bacteria starts to take over and creates an acidic environment in this whipped cream and pushes out the bacteria. And you want it to let it breathe a little bit. I've got cheesecloth that I put over my beaker, but you can definitely use any other container. I had some out here, but you can also use something like this, but just don't put the lid down on tight because you want it to breathe. And I just put this on here like this and let this sit on my counter for 2 days. And then I will come back and show you how I convert this into buttermilk, cultured buttermilk. Thanks for watching so far. I just wanted to add at this point that the flavor of your cultured butter is determined by the length of time that the culture gets to grow. So the intensity goes by each day. So if you're not sure of how much of a tang you want, after you've left it on your counter for 24 hours, taste it. And if it's not enough, then let it go for another day and then make your cultured butter that way. That way you're not too surprised by what the flavor is. Hello and welcome back. It's been 3 days, and now I'm gonna show you how to turn the cultured cream into cultured butter. And you're probably wondering, why, John, does this look like a mess? Because I started this videotaping and I got ahead of myself. And sometimes you do make mistakes in the kitchen, you gotta figure out what to do. And my mistake was, I went to separate the buttermilk before I actually turned it into butter. I don't know how I got ahead of myself until I realized I had messed up and I was using a different technique, using a cheesecloth to kind of wring it out. Well, I can't do that on this, so I'll have to do it the other way. Which I think the cheesecloth makes it a little bit easier because you can squeeze out that extra buttermilk before you do the pounding of the butter to separate the buttermilk from the butter. But hey, I'm not perfect. You're a witness to that today. So, and what I had said before, I like beakers because of the straight edges, because you can go straight down, scrape. Of course, I've lost a few of it at my creme fraiche, because that's what this is now, which is sort of like sour cream, but it's better than sour cream. It's got a lot more of a flavor to it, attain, and you can use this as any recipes as you would like that you would put sour cream in. And then we're going to put this in the mixer, and eventually it becomes whipped cream, and then it'll turn into butter. Now, the first time I did this, my kitchen was a little bit warm, and I don't know if that's going to happen today, but I found out that when it was pretty much at the edge of being completely into a solid butter, it really wasn't solidifying to a hard thing. And that was because it was too warm in here. So I stopped the mixer, put it in the refrigerator for about 10 minutes, let it cool down, brought it out, and that made it become a harder substance to work with because, you know, soft butter just doesn't work. So let's put this into the mixer. As you can see, it's quite thick. Well, it was a little bit thicker when I first poured it into the cheesecloth. Oh, Lord. But I figure we're going to still do this because I didn't want to wait for another 4 days, 3 days to create a whole new batch to start all over. And hey, you know, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And with us all being tied into our apartments for lockdown here in San Francisco, might as well make the best of everything, right? And if you hear a lot of pounding above me, that's my neighbor who's also been in his apartment, and I think he uses his kitchen to do his gym stuff. So occasionally, it's usually about this time, I start hearing a lot of pounding going on up there. So I think he's got his rowing machine or something going on. So I apologize that if that is the case. This I will not waste. I will definitely eat this. I might even do baked potatoes and add that with my regular sour cream that's in the refrigerator. And let's put this blender on here. Oops, this is deep. I almost made the wrong mistake. Don't laugh at my messy, unorganized cabinet. Always cut that out. All right, I'm gonna use the whisk. As you can see, I am not the most neatest cook in the kitchen, especially this tiny little studio apartment kitchen that I have. So we are gonna whisk this. Everything's backwards when you don't do it the way you do it cooking. This is gonna take about 5 minutes. I'm gonna whip it up, and then I will come back to you after it turns into a solid where I go from there. Okay, well, I thought I'd stopped it, but apparently I didn't. I don't even know what you... I may have to start this whole thing over again. But anyway, had an electrical issue. Figured that one out. It's a new power strip. And now it's into butter and buttermilk. I'm going to pour it in the strainer, get the buttermilk separated, and then we'll put it in a bowl, and then we're going to give it a wash to turn it to get rest of the butter milk out of the butter, because you definitely want to do that, because that will make the butter go bad much quicker if you don't get all of the buttermilk out. So let's just do this. Get this out of the way. Okay. And my butter kind of looks soft. I mean, if it was a little bit cooler in here, I think it would be much more of a block. And if you think it's still too soft, like I said, you can just stick it in your refrigerator for a little bit, chill it down to turn it into more of a solid block, which I might end up doing once I get when I start putting the ice water to do the bath, that's gonna give it a chill too. So I kinda wanna get as much of this good buttermilk out of here so I don't waste any of it. So I'm just kind of moving this around a little bit. I don't want to push it through the strainer. Not that there's anything wrong with getting any butter in your buttermilk. Okay, I think that's going to do it. Bowl here. Have my ice water. I don't have butter claws, so I'm going to use two different kinds of spatulas, and we're going to like knead this a little bit to separate the butter, and then we're going to add water until that water turns clear. That's when you know that you've got all the buttermilk out, and then you can kind of keep working it until you get the water out, and then we form it. Refrigerated, and voila, you've got yourself butter right there. So let's transfer this into here. It now came out pretty clear. And I started thinking to myself, well, you know what, even though it was a little soft, and I've got ice water here, it's got ice cubes in it. And when I was washing it out, I noticed that the butter was getting a lot harder too. And I'm thinking, well, maybe if I had a little more patience and I put that ice cold water in there while that slush was in there, let it sit for just a tiny bit and press it a little bit, I bet you it would have hardened that butter than sticking it in there and then bringing it back out. But they don't tell you that on some of these videos, but I'm telling you, so you got that idea. So you learned that one from me. And if it doesn't work, you know, you can always stick it back in the refrigerator. So. Anyway, so got all this done, went ahead of myself, lost some of my cream because I forgot about turning it into butter before, you know, straining it. And then the mixer wouldn't start, couldn't figure it out. I guess the extension cord has a weird bit to it, whatever. Okay, now, once you get it all clear, you definitely want to keep pressing it for some more to get as much of that water out of there. Let me tell you, even after I do this, it always never seems to be quite right. But if you're going to use it, keep it in the refrigerator. I don't think you're going to have a problem. But I always keep my butter out on the counter because I like it soft. So now what we're going to do, it's my little thing to start the video. Sometimes I do it right, sometimes I don't. So we'll find out if I did it right. Now we're gonna form it. It's pretty chill, so it shouldn't be too bad. So you can use parchment. I'm using the seal, what is it? The press and seal to do it. I've used parchment before. Parchment's great. I just didn't like the fact that it didn't stay together as a package. So I figured this, I can form it, wrap it all up, it'll stick. Now, normally you could add salt to it. Did you notice I didn't put any salt in it? That will help it preserve a little bit more. To come to think of it, well, why not? Haven't done anything right so far in this video. I'm gonna add some salt to it. See? It's a nice thing about you learn about cooking. Yeah, you screw up, just go figure out how you can move ahead. Sorry. how you can move ahead and work with what you got and what you just did. Life, also life is just sort of that way anyway. I am just doing this by guessing. I figure a little bit in there is better than nothing, and you know, you can always add that salt, whatever it is that you're doing. If you're gonna cook with this and you don't put any salt in it, that's even better, right? Because you don't need to. If you're gonna make this for cooking, then you don't put any salt in it. You wanna know a little secret? Sometimes I use the salt butter. I never really notice that much of a difference, but then again, a lot of the recipes I'm using, they're not using too much salt anyway. So it probably doesn't do much good. But I'm sure it does. I'm sure someone out there is gonna say, yeah, it does. But you gotta use sometimes what you got on hand and live with it. All right. So, I got a little salt in there. I'm sure that's probably not enough when I start using it, but. So, that's all I'm gonna do. It's just, I'm gonna figure out sort of a block. Let's try this. Not really moving well for me. In a shape, it's not definitely, this is going to fit in my butter block, so I cut it in pieces. So what I might do, because I've done it before when I left it in this big block, was a pain in the butt to cut it, because it's always in the refrigerator, then I might actually put some cuts in it. And that will make it a little bit easier. Like playing with clay at the ceramic studio. It can make me a butter sculpture. All right. Yeah, not the perfect little log, but hey, it'll do. Let's guess. I'm gonna make it in blocks this way. That way I know it will fit on my little glass butter tray. I'm probably gonna have some toasted butter bread after this. See, I already see butter, water seeping out of it, and I generally find it always coming out during the week. I just drain it off, let it roll off. There you go. There's a nice block of butter. Of course, it takes you some time, but the end result, you made it, it's homemade, tastes really great, and it's a nice little achievement in your life amongst all this other crap that's happening right now. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it, and thank you if you kept on listening to me rambling and got something out of this. Of course, I'll probably do another one, hopefully a little bit better, without any issues, but I can't promise you that. There's always issues in my life. One way or another, but you work your way around that and things come out better at the end. Anyway, love you all. Be safe. Wash your hands. Wear a mask if you possibly can, because it's just, if anything, keeping people from spraying in your face when they cough or talk to you. It's always a good thing. Anyway, take care. And hopefully we get through this all really quickly. Love you. Bye-bye.